All right, hey everyone, how's it going?
Today we're going to be taking off,
let's see if that's in focus, yep. This part here, so this is like the oil release plug basically. So let's put that up there. You see if you can unlock that, pull it out, and then drain it, it'll drain all the oil. Now I've already done that, but what I'm going to do today is actually undo the connector, whatever you call it, here, because I'm going to be putting a longer one of these in, so that way it can drain over top of the frame. So we're going to be taking that out. And I'll be honest, I don't know where my other wrench is, so we're down to the red today. See how that goes. And I'll have this kind of on standby because I don't know how much more oil is going to come out, if any. I'm sure some will. To be honest with you, I might flip this engine because. Flip the engine in case that some oil does come out. I'm gonna move all my parts real fast. And let's go ahead and flip this so at least it's sitting up. That way when I take it out, it's not gonna drain all over the place. Okay. Let's get a better wrench. This thing. I was using this thing, piece of junk. Yeah, I don't know where my other one is. It's somewhere, but not here. No idea what size that is. 3/4. Nope. 7/8. A little bigger. 13/16. Oh my goodness. All right. I guess we're not using that. Let's use this other one. I used to use this one fishing, so this is about as clean as you would think, and saltwater fishing too a little bit, so this thing has been rusted out. And then I used to live in Florida, and I would spray, wait, is this still in focus? Okay, I was like, that's not in focus anymore, that would have been a real bummer. There we go. I used to live in Florida though, and I would spray a lot of my tools with that Rust-Oleum clear enamel, this stuff here, to prevent a lot of them from rusting. It works really well, and I sprayed these a while back before I went fishing, saltwater fishing with them, and I would use them to hooks off fish and stuff, so this has been in the sea many times, and it wasn't really rusted. All right, so we took that out. You can see this kind of a real short short kind of valve. It'll focus. I don't know if that's gonna autofocus, but you can see where it kind of, you can twist it if it'll let me. You can pull it out and that kind of opens the valve to drain. And then obviously close it and then close the part. So we're not gonna be using this just like it is. I think I'll look at what other people did. Might just put another like coupler from here to there so I can keep the, because the valve is good, right? Like I want to keep that, but I just need something to extend it. So we'll definitely need to match the threads, but I really need to get it out about here so that way it goes over the frame of the lawnmower. So that'd be ideal. And I'm dripping oil like crazy on the bottom. Jeez. All right, hold on. See that?
coming out. Let's clean that up. Always good to have cat litter just kind of around, that way it can absorb all the oil. And you should be able to just sweep it up later. Makes kind of clean up real easy, especially if there's more coming out. All right, let's get a little more. Kind of get in the habit of, you kind of get in the habit of keeping this stuff on hand, especially if you ever worked on like four-wheelers and stuff that have a tendency to leak. All right. I guess we'll tip the engine back up since it is leaking a lot. I need to drain the rest anyway, but I don't want to do that now. I might go ahead and actually take off the rest of the throttle cabling while I'm at it, to be honest with you. So just at the top here, I'm just going to go ahead and take off the rest of that stuff while I'm at it. And let's see. These real small wrenches. I'm a big fan of this setup already because I'm literally right next to all my stuff. I don't really have to move a lot. But yeah, I've already taken off most of the carburetor and everything like that, so this is going to be really the last of the mechanical parts, on, at least on the outside of the engine anyway. And then we have the fun task of remembering how it all went back together. I don't know about you guys, but I never really get too, like, I never get too nervous about that step. Well, let me see if I have a I gotta find a bit for that one. There we go. But yeah, I never really get too nervous about like the reassembly step of this, of the whole thing. Just because I feel like it helps you learn. Like if you take the stuff apart and then you're like, you know. You're looking at it, you're like, oh man, you know, how does this go back together? But it helps you learn, you know, actually figure it out and learn how the parts are working. But it even, oh my goodness, it even allows you to, just
I dropped a bit in the engine. Yikes, I'll get that out in a second. Take off all this stuff here. There's a lot going on with this that I would love to be able to I'd love to be able to simplify a bit if we can. Okay. I mean, like, this stuff always fascinated me. I mean, look at how many screw, like, springs, levers. I mean, there's just so much happening. Try to fish that bit out with you guys see where that went? It went literally in. So I've got the bit out. I'm gonna try to sweep up some of this oil. Thank you.
Okay.
Now we have this one to take off here. And trying to find my pliers. Where in the world I put those things? I set my onion on accidentally. Nope. I drop them? Where did they go? These things. Little pin there holding that in.
found the pliers. They were in like some random drawer.
All right. I think we have all that loose kind of stuff off, mostly. So now I think I'm good to take the top cylinder off and then hopefully split the crankcase open. But I don't have time to do that tonight, and that will be the next one. But these bolts, I think this is going to be... I'm going to have to look up how to split this properly to see what's going on. And smells like classic bad gas. So I think this was... I think it was just sitting for a while. It smells like bad gas. But yeah, well, once we've got this open, we're going to clean the engine off and make it nice. Make it a nice engine. But I hate all the just electrical nonsense on here. I don't know. I'm just not a fan of that stuff. Like send charge back to the battery. You got all the voltage regulators. You got the... I don't know. I'm just really more into the pure mechanical stuff. I'm really fascinated how that can work with zero electrical components to just add just overly complex parts. Anyway, so I think that's what we're going to call it tonight. Next time we'll be a little more involved, I think, in the case. All right, guys, I'll see you.